Hey, I'm Jason Croom, founder of Swagger Crew. I'm in my 20s, and I've been dancing for about 15 years now. I love dance because it's the voice of movement. Singers can use their voice to make you feel a certain way about a song, where dancers use movement to make you feel the same emotion, the same way about a song, and I think it's beautiful. Some of my interests include acting and shooting a short film. I love to be able to tell stories. I'm a storyteller, you know? I like to make films that are enjoyable for people to watch, but also make them think. I'm born and raised in Brooklyn, New York. I don't know if you can hear the accent. It's in there. Brooklyn, New York. You know, but I love Atlanta. A-Town. Bow, 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 as they say. I went to school to become a network engineer, Cisco network engineer. If you don't know what that is, this has to do with computers, IT. I actually started a job as a help desk personnel for 10 months, and it was like prison because I was in a cubicle. And if you know anything about creative people in cubicles, they do not mix. So I had to get out of there, and I had to start focusing on what made me happy, which was dance. We got the privilege of going on America's Best Dance Crew, MTV, and it was a great opportunity and even a better experience. And even the blessings that came after the show, you know, we got the chance to represent President Obama, Secretary Clinton in the Bahamas for the U.S. Embassy. It was just a great experience. I've never been to the Bahamas, so it was good. And then the best thing about it was to be there with my brothers and sisters. Something else that I believe deeply in is philanthropy, you know, giving back to the community. We started a program called Swagger Crew Fit Kids Campaign. And what it is a prevention for childhood obesity. We're using that in conjunction with the First Lady Michelle Obama's Let's Move initiative. What we're doing is we're using dance fitness as a way to motivate kids to get off the couch and stay healthy. If you want to learn more about that, you can go to our website, www.swaggercrewfitkids.com. And you can check out some of the stuff we're doing and some of the Atlanta organizations that we're partnered with. As most people know, we had a house fire that did a lot of damage. The crazy thing about it was that my mom was still home when the house fire occurred. And the scariest thing was getting a phone call from my dad to say that there was a house fire and he couldn't get in contact with her. So it was a lot of things going through my head. To God, she got out alive. But we lost a lot of stuff, a lot of memories. And we since moved back into the house, but, you know, because we lost so much with what's going on in the house fire, it still doesn't feel like home, even being home, if you know what I mean. So just trying to rebuild from that, trying to move on and, you know, and keep the family strong has been the struggle right now. Swagger Crew actually rallied to my family. You know, they offered clothes, they offered furniture, you know, anything they could do, they were there for me. And it's crazy, like, you never really know who your family is until you're in that time of need. And I can definitely say that Swagger is more than just the people, a couple people that I dance with, you know. They actually put together a fundraiser for us, so they had performances from local other crews that came out and perform, and they hosted it. And it was just, you know, everybody was crying. I'm not gonna lie, everybody was crying. It was real emotional and touching to see that kind of love from people that are not your family, you know? So I definitely appreciate that. And shouts out to Swagger for that. I think the greatest thing that someone can do is to follow their passion, even if they don't know how far the passion will take them. You know, we were on the TV show, and we didn't know how far it was going to take us. Even when we got off the show, we didn't know how far it was going to take us, you know? But, you know, just the opportunities that came after that. You know, we got sponsored by Osiris Shoe Company, which is like one of the top skateboarding sneaker companies out there. And, you know, they're working with us to do other things. And then there was Post Atlanta, which is a convention of nothing but the judges from So You Think You Can Dance. And to be able to hear them say, you know, oh, that was crazy, or your show was like so dope. And, you know, these are like Mia Michaels and Wade Robinson and Dave Scott and Tyce D'Oreo, and the list goes on. And you're like, what? you like my show? Nice. You know, and be able to get that feedback and talk to them about, you know, different things within the industry. It was just, it was great. And then we turn around and we see that same passion and love in the students that invite us to come out and teach workshops and to perform. So, you know, we just want to say, you know, thank you to all the fans that supported us, you know, before we got on the show, and definitely the fans that continue to support us after the show. We do this for you. Yeah?
From